welcome to WCW Saturday Night. Tony Schiavone and the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. Last Sunday, capacity crowd, people all over the world watching as Rowdy Roddy Piper defeats Hollywood Hulk Hogan, proving he is the icon in our sport. But as you saw at the top of the program, and as we will show you later on, it didn't stop there with Hulk Hogan and the New World Order. It all happened on WCW Monday Nitro.
Yeah, but first of all, it was such a glorious night for historians, for traditionalists, if you will. We are talking Roddy Piper, outmanned, undersized, heart as big as the whole state of Oregon, if you will, came to fight the fight of his life. And we seen Hollywood Hulk Hogan go better by his stock. He's gonna talk a lot about it tonight on the Saturday night kicking off 97. But the Giant still got something to say in this whole mix as we look at the NWO first pay-per-view.
It is time now for action here on WCW Saturday night. What a month of January 1997 it's gonna be for World Championship Wrestling Nitro. This Monday, Monroe, Louisiana. Next Monday, we're gonna be in New Orleans at the Superdome. The 20th of January, Chicago, the United Center. And also the 21st, the Clash of the Champions returns live here to TBS, the Superstation Dream.
Well, right here on the mothership on TBS, we kick off another great year, 1997. What will it hold? Where will we go from here? Where will the NWA be at the end of this thing?
Well, we do know, fans. We do have a major announcement today concerning the NWO sold-out pay-per-view on Saturday night, January 25th. Jimmy Richland now pounding away on Chris Jericho. The Giant and Hulk Hogan have signed the match for the World Heavyweight title, and these two men will collide in the main event on Saturday, January 25th. Look at that Mexican arm drag over the top and a hip toss by Chris Jericho.
Did you see how he said that? And they will clash on the 25th. Look at that Mexican arm drag. I'm telling you, right on top of all the action. It's going so fast. Sometimes you got to pull the reins back. Bottom line, we're going to talk about today how this thing came about with the Giant and Hogan. But can I say this right off the bat?
Right off the
bat. The appropriate name for the NWO. The appropriate name for that pay-per-view. Sold out. Hogan. Sold out America. Sold out the kid. Sold out the country. It don't mean sold out like no more seats sold out. To me, it means I sold out the industry of professional wrestling. That's what it means to me. And what a pay-per-view I hear that's going to be.
Well, certainly it is not, we do not want to promote the NWO's pay-per-view. However, we're going to show you a little bit later on in this telecast, near the end of the program, what happened at the end of Nitro, what happened at the hands of Hulk Hogan and the NWO to Roddy Piper and to the Giant. And apparently, the foundation of this New World Order starting to crack a little bit.
Not so fast. Not so fast. We got to talk a lot about it. You're right, in a way. But there's also other things to talk about with Piper. Oh, man, did he put him betty-to-betty-to-body. I guarantee you, his eyes went in the back of his head. He went out colder than a drum. Tradition, history, put him to sleep. Piper came out victorious, but couldn't let it lay there. And we're going to talk more about that. Chris Jericho, 97, told me before we came on tonight in the dressing room area, he said, Dream, I want this to be so special. I'm setting my goals on something. I said, what is that? He said, I want to be United States Heavyweight Wrestling Champion. Whether he can or not, we will see. He wants a major title, though.
Congratulations, Eddie Guerrero wins the U.S. Heavyweight title, but Six has the belt. And those two men are going to collide at NWO Sold Out coming up in January, and we'll be talking about that match. Here's a lateral press by Richland. One, two, got a two count. By the way, we're also going to have a match where Chris Jericho will face Masahiro Chono. Chono, a newest member of the New World Order, and he and Jericho, kind of a return match from when Chono got disqualified against Jericho and tried to cripple him a couple of weeks ago on Nitro. One almost got a three count. Did Jim Richland that time.
Yeah, that would be a major upset. But I guarantee you, we've seen it all happen this past year going into the new here on the mothership here on TBS. But I guarantee you one thing, major upset was there. Let me say something else about the sold-out thing, right? Okay.
S-O-U-L-E-D, as in heart and sold out.
Yeah, he sold out. I told you that.
I know.
So let me tell you this other thing, too. There's an awful lot of WCW guys on that sold-out thing. A lot of guys. Because you know what? I think we got them on the run, like you said.
One, two.
And now we got to continue to just bear down if that's what you want to do or me want to do or they want to do. I'm not so sure that everybody is into WCW's fold. You know what I mean?
You're saying there are still bad seeds on this side somewhere.
Yeah, people close.
Ducking a clothesline. Over the top, 1, 2. And Jericho got a two count that time on Jim Richland, who goes right to the eyes once again. NWO Sold Out is on Saturday, the 25th of January. From Cedar Rapids, Iowa, the Four Seasons Center.
Wow.
There's a back kick that time.
Nice one.
And 1, 2. And the event is not sold out as of yet. Great seats available at the Five Seasons Center box office and all Ticketmaster locations. Get your tickets early, though. Should be a big event for the New World Order, their very first pay-per-view. Up on the middle, turnbuckle!
Yeah, Jericho is really getting it taken to him right here. He made two major mistakes, and that was one of them right there. And I guarantee you one thing, he needs to be looking a lot better going into 97 than he's looking right now. But I think he still has the opportunity to go ahead and get some of his dream fulfilled right here at WCW with a big boy play. Nobody home.
Moonsault attempt by Richland. Not a bad one at all, but it did not connect. And now Chris Jericho. Oh, my.
That's folding
one,
it up.
1, 2, 3. The missile drop kick from the top. And Chris Jericho gets the win in the opening bout here on WCW Saturday night.
I'm going to tell you what. Why are you pointing me and screaming? Yes, I know. That was good. He moved on up. He looked good at times and didn't look too good at other times. Bottom line, Mr. Jericho starts the year with a victory right here on Saturday night. And we are talking TBS. What's that hook? Got a duck under this thing right here. Got a little back flipperooski there into a sabot. As you said, a back kick. And go ahead and get him covered. Who's going to do it? Is Stagger Lee doing this thing?
Of course he
is. You know, I refuse to throw it, but the producer said I got to. So I'm going to throw it to him. Okay. Lee Marshall, go ahead. Take it.
Now, the first thing I need to do is apologize to the American Dream, Dusty Rhodes. A couple of weeks ago, I was doing an interview, and Dusty, as we said, pitched it to me, and I said, thank you, Tony. Well, the reason is, all our floor director said was, Lee, you're going to get a pitch from the good-looking one, so I just assumed, you know. Anyway, coming up the 25th of January from Cedar Rapids, Iowa, I kind of hate to be a pitch man for this, but it is indeed the very first NWO pay-per-view. They call it Sold Out. Masahiro Chono, who recently joined the NWO, is going to be facing this young man who you just saw in action, Chris Jericho. The last time you and Chono got together, you actually won that match, Chris, but he did have you tied up like a Christmas present.
That's right. In true NWO fashion, Chono had me when I was down, when I was beat, and he got disqualified. Chono, I got one victory over you. Everyone seems to forget, though, the very first member of the NWO to lose was Nick Patrick. And I was the one who made him lose. He was the weakest link in the chain. He was the weakest link in the NWO.
Now, let me ask you, Chris, if you're feeling any additional pressure, because distinctly, this is not a home court advantage for any WCW athletes. It is the NWO's pay-per-view, and let's face it, you're going into the enemy's camp.
I'm in the enemy's camp, but let me tell you this, Lee. I know what it takes to beat a member of the NWO, and a few other guys in WCW do as well. Chono, Sold Out, NWO pay-per-view, I'm going to be the first one to take you out in WCW. Welcome to America.
Yeah, and welcome to Saturday night on TBS. More action coming your way.